Hey everyone, it's Mike. I review nootropics and I talk personal development. And during this video today, you're going to learn about four nootropics that you can use to increase your testosterone levels naturally. And these nootropics, they work for me. They'll likely work for you as well. Firstly, let's look into Tongkat Ali. This is also known as Longjack. It's a herbal remedy that's been used for centuries, also known as Malaysian ginseng. And the way in which one would use this is taking 200 to 300 milligrams once per day, ideally in the morning. And what you can expect from it is after about 2 weeks of consistent use, believe me, you should notice increased sex drive, probably better lifts in the weight room, even a little bit of decrease in fat mass. That's been my experience with it. I've now been using it for about 2 months straight, and I'm really happy with some of the results. And we can see all the signs of good indications that one's testosterone levels are improving, from erections, libido, decreased levels of stress, increase in subjective well-being. And this is neat too in that there's research showing that's effective in decreasing cortisol levels. So that could perhaps be one of the mechanisms in which it does increase your testosterone levels by decreasing your stress levels a little bit. As this study here shows that during 24 weeks, there was 63 subjects mixed both male and female, and it was shown that cortisol reduced by 16% and testosterone increased by 37%. I have found with Tongkat Ali that the brand really does matter, so I would recommend that you do your research, find a reputable brand that has positive reviews with it. I found mine. I like the Nootropics Depot version, and 200 to 300 milligrams once per day, ideally in the morning, really works well for me. There's no real acute effects. You shouldn't notice it increase your energy or testosterone immediately. And so you know, the powder tastes absolutely horrible, so I would highly recommend that you do go ahead and get the capsule version, especially if you're somebody that cannot tolerate some of those bad tasting nootropics. And I made a more in-depth video on Tongkat Ali, which I will link here, where you'll learn about some of the benefits alongside with the benefit of increasing your testosterone levels. Here's nootropic number two. It's ZMA. Come to think of it, like three supplements packed into one. It's got zinc, it's got magnesium, and it's got vitamin B6. This has a lot of promise in the bodybuilding community to help you build more muscle and lose more fat. I wouldn't really say it does too much that way, but specifically if you are somebody that does feel some symptoms of having low zinc or low magnesium, I would highly recommend it, because one thing you'll definitely notice taking ZMA is an increased sleep quality, waking up a little bit more recharged, rejuvenated. And if you're somebody that typically needs like 8 hours of sleep per day, you'll likely find that when you're taking ZMA, you'll only need 7 hours and you'll be able to feel just as well the following day. Many people refer to zinc as the most important mineral in the body. It does a lot as far as energy levels. It can actually decrease acne. There's a whole host of benefits, and especially if you're somebody that's not eating a lot of meat or zinc-rich foods, then I would highly recommend that you do check out either zinc by itself or ZMA. And as far as magnesium is concerned, that's where a lot of people use it for sleep. So this is from bodybuilding.com. They say take three capsules within 30 to 60 minutes before bedtime, preferably on an empty stomach. So in a practical sense, what that may look like is having dinner at 7, taking your ZMA at 9, and then falling asleep at 10 o'clock. Let's move on to nootropic number 3, which is Tribulus Terrestris. The brand really does matter. This is from Now Sports. I've been taking this for probably 5 or 6 years now. I'm typically using 1 gram right before bed, and sometimes I'll take it in the morning as well. I've not really found there's any bad side effects if you take 1 gram in the morning and 1 gram before bed. And believe me, this is something which actually works. You'll notice it working, especially if you're somebody which maybe has lower testosterone levels or like mid to low testosterone levels. And what you can experience is more aggression, better energy levels. I found that my sleep is a lot better. I'm waking up much more recharged, much more rejuvenated, and I'm really just more excited to get to the weight room. This is something I take almost every single day, and what I'm finding is whenever I run out of Tribulus, it's very obvious. Like at the weight room, I feel pains in my joints. I'm not as likely to hit PRs, personal records, with specific lifts. Everything just seems to feel a little bit better with Tribulus, and at the same time, I'm more energized and I feel like it's very natural. It's not an artificial energy. I don't feel uneasy or jittery. So for that reason, I would highly recommend it. You'll typically find it in like a capsule or a tablet of either 750 milligrams or 1 gram. So if you're only gonna take it once per day, I would recommend it. You take it within an hour of sleeping, similar to taking ZMA. And if you're gonna take it twice a day, then ideally something like once in the morning and once right before bed. I wouldn't be surprised if you commented afterwards and saying it was effective for you as well. It's really no surprise that Tribulus is one of those nootropics that is in a number of testosterone boosting blends, and the ones which don't have Tribulus in them don't seem to have as good ratings. Here's what the pill looks like. It's an unusually large shape pill, but this is one thing which I would absolutely never take in the powder form, because It not only does it taste awful, it has a strange texture. You can brush your teeth as much as you'd like. You can rinse your mouth, but the taste will not go away. So tablet or capsule is a must in my opinion. All right, nootropic number four, and perhaps this is the most popular one, is ashwagandha. As we can see in this study over here, what they did was they had 46 male patients tested over the course of 90 days versus a placebo group, and they found that there was an increase of testosterone levels and a decrease in cortisol levels. And ashwagandha, it's been around for so long that there are so many studies showing just this again and again and again. I would say that ashwagandha hasn't really had that benefit specifically in increasing my testosterone levels. However, I have found that it has helped me to induce a better state of mind. I found at the end of the day, I'm more easily able to tune off from work, enjoy my time off, and able to get better sleep as a result. However, when it comes to boosting testosterone levels, I think the other three are a lot more stronger at that specifically. With ashwagandha, more so a decrease of cortisol levels, especially if you're somebody that people consider to be stressed out, like you have racing thoughts, like you're always in a hurry and you're rushed, then ashwagandha, believe me, I think it will help you to relax a little bit more. And who knows, you could experience, just like Tongkat Ali, a boost of testosterone as a result. So with ashwagandha, it's a really different dosing protocol than the other nootropics in that you need to be taking it twice a day for a consistent period. For me, I find it's very effective after about 2 weeks. There's various forms of it. I've made a couple videos on it, which you may find helpful. This video here is ashwagandha, my whole experience with it. And in this video here, I will actually outline some of the different types of ashwagandha, because there's KSM 66, there's Sensoral. There's a lot of different ways of taking ashwagandha. You can take it in like a tea in a powder form, or you can take it in the extract. So my preferred way of taking it is the KSM 66 version. I'm taking 300 milligrams twice per day. I prefer not taking it in the morning because it is somewhat relaxing. Like once in the afternoon, 300 milligrams, and then perhaps 4 hours afterwards, another 300 milligrams. After a few weeks, you'll feel a lot more relaxed. You'll have a better relationship to work, and you'll find it a lot easier to be consistent with some of your daily habits. If you're somebody that needs to do particular tasks during the day and they're a bit mundane, they're a bit repetitive, let me know what your thoughts are on these particular nootropics in the comment section below. There's obviously a lot of different things you can do to boost your testosterone levels, especially working out, specifically like a lower rep range of 4 to 6 reps of like squats, bench press, deadlifting. When it comes to eating, I would highly recommend that you do make sure you're getting enough healthy fats, specifically saturated fats. There's some science showing that it can improve your testosterone levels quite significantly. Of course, sleep well, hydrate well, watch your alcohol intake. And of course, I can make another video talking about some other hacks outside of nootropics. I appreciate all of you, and the way I'm gonna end off this video is with an insertion of another video which I made on ashwagandha. You'll likely find that helpful, and I'll look forward to seeing you all next time. Browse through examine.com. We can see here there's results with ashwagandha with respect to decreasing anxiety, improving your levels of testosterone, decreasing cortisol levels, improving your power output, and its very significant effects with respect to reducing levels of stress.